Hello everybody, it's Niklas and welcome to this new video. And in this video we are going to see how in Blender we can generate landscape, and for this we will use an extensions. Subscribe to this YouTube channel if you like the content. First link on the description, the complete course Blender is available. So if you want to learn Blender step by step with a curve structure, it is on the first link on the description. You will see the model, the details of the course, what you will be able to learn in this course. So let's start. I'm going to click on the cube and just press delete on the keyboard. And if you want to have access to the extensions, we can just go on the left, and here we can use edit, and we will select the preferences. After to select the preferences, you can go into extensions, and you have multiple extensions that you can use. This is all the extensions that you can use in Blender when you open Blender, but it's also possible to import extension. But first, when you go here, you have a lot of type of extensions. So now from this, if I just go on the top here, I can find interesting extensions, and it is this one, Add Mesh. And you have the Add Mesh and Landscape. So we can activate this one. And after to activate this one, you will be able to generate landscape using Add Mesh. And now you can find landscape here. If I just click on landscape, I can zoom a little bit just on this area. And you can have access to the options on the left here. After to have access to the options, first things to understand, it is to select what type of landscapes you want in the operator presets. So this is the default that we have. So if you want something like a canyon, you can select this canyon. If you want another type of canyon, you can select also, for example, this one by default. If you want to generate a mountain, you have this one, but you can also use another type of mountain. If you want to generate a lake, you have, for example, also this one. And if you want to generate another type of lake, you have also this one. When you generate a lake, you will have two meshes, but when you generate something little different, you will have only one meshes. You can also even create a volcano if you want. If you want to create something like a rock, it's also possible. If you want a river, it's possible, as you can see. So let's start because we have the default here, and we have also the default large. So default on this area, and we can find the default large just like this. So if I select just the default to see as an example, I will come back here and I will select default. So in my operator presets, and I will come back to default. First, you can work with a number of subdivisions. So if you want, for example, less details, you can decrease the subdivision. So here we have 40, and on this area, I can put 40. But if I want to have more details, I can put like 160, and I can put 160 also on this area. You can change the mesh size. It is generally better if you want to keep the ratios that to change after. If you just continue, so this is just a basic parameter. After, you have the noise settings, so you can click, and noise settings, you have different options like the noise type. It depends on what you choose. So if you choose a different operator preset, you won't have exactly the same parameter. So for example, here I can change, I can use something like turbulence, or I can just come back with this one. I can select the noise type also. You have different type of options. And if you want to have a different view, you can select a random scene value, as you can see. If I just come back here, you can create an offset x-axis, create an offset on the y-axis. And you have also the possibility to change the size on the x-axis and on the y-axis. If I just continue a little bit, you have the noise size also. So if you want to have something more like that, you can increase the noise size, or you can have more details if you decrease the noise size. If I continue a little bit, everything is about the noise here, so you can change the dimension. But if, for example, you go something like this, you will have a maximum. Why you will have a maximum? For a simple reason that you need to work in the display setting. And in the display setting, you have the 8 maximum minimum. What does it mean? It means that if you increase the 8 like this, and your value is higher than the maximum, you will have something flat on the top, just like this. So if you don't want to have this, you need to increase the maximum And when you increase the maximums, if the value is higher than the 8, like for example here, you can work like this. So if you don't want to have something flat on the top, you need to focus to have higher value for the maximum that you have for the 8. But you can also create something flat like this if you are interested. You can create some offset, and you can also work with the maximum here, or you have also in the other direction. If you want to go in the other direction, it is possible because you can go inside also and generate something like this, as you can see. And so something that I'm going to do is to just come back and create something, yes, just here, and I will decrease my maximum value and I will increase my offset a little bit, and here I can change the 8. Well, the problem is the maximum value, and let's decrease the maximum value here, and I can generate something like that. You can even have a file of levels and water plane, so it means you can use a water plane here. You will have a second mesh on this area. If you just press left click, you can validate your drone. And after, you can, for example, I don't want the water plane, I can just delete this mesh. And you can also scale after. If I scale on the Z axis, SZ, you can also make some transformation, as you can see. So it is a convenient tool to, in a fast way, generate something like that. After, you can have more options, and you can go and add mesh landscape. And if I select landscape here, I can select another operation preset, like we have this type of canyon, for example. And if you select canyon, you will have other type of preset. So one more time, subdivision, mesh size. But here in this case, we have almost the same type of preset to generate a canyon. But you can change one more time the noise type and the turbulence here also to create something different. If I select another operator preset, I want to create something like rocks, for example, it's definitely also possible. You can do this type of work with modifiers, and like the displace modifier using a texture, but you can also use this one. You can work with your number of subdivision on the X and on the Y axis, but you can also decrease if you need less. I can put 100, and for example, I can put 100 here. One more time, I can work with my mesh size, as you can see. Change the noise type. If I want a different type of render, I can change my noise type just here. Something that I can do also is to work with a noise base, just like this, and after we can focus with different type of parameter. So definitely every time you can adjust, you can make different type of choice depending of what you want to obtain. And in this case of the rocks, we can focus on the x-axis, y-axis to have different deep displacement render. And here you can definitely change to try to obtain really what you want. You can even increase the factor of distortions or decrease the factor of distortion, soft or hard. So definitely it is a convenient tool. If you just click here, you have also the possibility when you go on the options on the right, you can click on create. And in this option, you can also generate a new landscape from these panels. So don't forget that you can use the mesh option, but you can also drag and move these panels. And when you go on the right, you will have create and the possibility to generate a new landscape just here. So it's okay for that. We are going to stop here for this video. If you like this content, subscribe to these YouTube channels. First link on the description, the complete course Blender is available. So if you want to learn Blender step by step with a curve structure, it will be on the first link on the description. It is a complete guide, a lot of hours of training content to perfectly master Blender from scratch and to start from beginner levels to obtain very great advanced levels for 3D modeling and also for a realistic render. So first link on the description, complete course Blender, you will see the models, the sessions, what you will be able to learn. For next video on these channels, see you, ciao ciao.